September 22nd, 1968, Mario Andretti in the Trenton 200, the USAC Trenton 200 that Mario goes on.
In the late 1960s, it was known as the Speedway of the North, playing host to big crowds and big names in racing.
A.J. Foyt, everybody knows A.J. A.J. Won many races at Trenton. He was a crowd pleaser. They loved him. Eddie Sachs was like Sam Nunes' favorite son. Eddie Sachs loved Trenton Speedway. Mario Andretti cut his teeth at Trenton. He ran there well. Jim Herdeby, Bobby Unser, and we even had the NASCAR stars here, like Richard Petty was here, Cale Yarborough. Trenton was a great racetrack.
Dick Ivins had a love for the Trenton Speedway and shot many of the races on film.
And it was on a half-mile dirt track. The crowds were there. The excitement was there. And as a youngster, to me, there was nothing like auto racing.
But long before race cars sped around the Trenton Speedway, in the beginning, it was just a horse track at the old New Jersey fairgrounds.
The Trenton Speedway was a horse racing half-mile dirt track. And then in the early 40s, they got the idea, George Hammett Sr. brought in auto racing, and all the fairs across the country seemed to have auto racing along with the fair dates.
The Trenton Speedway officially opened in 1900 and was one of the first of its kind in the country. Dirt racing lasted for nearly 60 years until the track was paved in 1957. Then in 1969, the track was expanded to a mile and a half and an unusual shape.
When they went to the mile and a half, they kind of made it like kidney-shaped because they couldn't expand to the outside because the back stretch was right against those homes on a back stretch. So they had to bring it to the left, in, and then like this and around. So that it was probably one of the strangest tracks I've ever seen in the country. For the mechanics to set the cars up, that was also a problem. You're getting the car to set up to the left and right turns.
The Trenton Speedway hosted 8 NASCAR Grand National events, and during its peak was one of the most exciting stops for race fans.
And it was an icon for us in the area. The crowds came, and it was great. It was a great time of my life.
And some fans are still missing all that high-powered noise.
But it was a great speedway, and plus it was in my backyard. And I could hear them right here from my home.